accurate, Carolyn, because I said one winner, but really and truly, all of these ladies are winners for this evening. I think for the last time, you should give all of these ladies a round of applause. And also a round of applause to our judges who had no easy task tonight, I am sure. It was a very, very difficult evening for them to select only one who will wear the crown and represent Barbados as they head to Miss World in London in November of this year. All right, so this is the moment you have all been waiting for. Our second runner-up, or the third place here this evening, is contestant number 5, Miss Urban Vice, Miss Shaquilla Fallon. Now we always like to say, with the first runner-up, you know the rules. If the winner, for any reason, should not be able to fulfill her duties, the first runner-up customarily takes her place, and that person will be.
Okay, first runner-up or second place would step into the spotlight should Miss World Barbados 2014 not be able to fulfill her duties is none other than number 8, Miss MQI Bellingham.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of Miss Barbados World 2014 is contestant number 1.
Thank you.
thank you very much for attending here this evening and good night.
Been a long journey and a lot of hard work, but it really did pay off, and I'm so excited. I can't wait to represent my country. I really do pride myself in representing Barbados, and I will do my best. I have won Miss Whole Town in 2012, and I won Miss Lodge School in 2010. I also competed in International Carnival Queen last year. And I also did, I'm also the Barbados International Carnival Queen for 2013. Well, I'm making my project a foundation now, so it will be a brand on its own, so that we can extend our initiative towards people within the community as well as the Caribbean. Thank you.
It is my first time in Barbados, and I'm very excited to be here. So far, aside from being at the Miss World Barbados competition, I have been at the beach, tanning it up, and enjoying the wonderful Bajan cuisine that you have here. I actually sadly leave tomorrow, so I have made the most out of it. So I was swimming with the turtles the other day. I went snorkeling to see the shipwrecks and just enjoying the beach basically, and the people who are so funny, who always brighten up my day. They always find a way to just make me smile for some reason. So I like the way that the community brings itself together. I thought the girls were really fantastic. They really, you know, tried their best, they did their best, and I thought the winner was just fantastic. I thought she was the best bet to represent Barbados this year at the Miss World Final. And, you know, hopefully she does well, she trains well, and that she continues with her Beauty with a Purpose project. I think my advice to her would be, do your Beauty with a Purpose project genuinely and wholeheartedly. And of course, to always be healthy and training, do well, focus on yourself and your confidence. And lastly, always be nice to the people around you. Well, my Beauty with a Purpose was to do relief efforts back at home, because we did have a lot of typhoons happening at that time. But my main advocacy has always been education for kids, and I think that's something that I could bring forward to as my reign in Miss World. My reign has actually been going very well. We've been traveling to a lot of countries and meeting a lot of different kids, seeing what they need, and making them happy. I mean, that's the most important thing, is to make them happy with the basic needs that they need. And it's been amazing. I'm here in Barbados. I mean, I never thought I would be here, so thank you for welcoming me to your beautiful country. Thank you.